So I am with my old friend,
Oz Recker. Hello, Oz. How are you?
I'm fine. Thanks, Carl.
Now, we're going to talk about the new LED F160 light that you've launched, because this is quite an innovative product. And I'll tell you why. Is I've actually been a little bit anti-LED in the past, yes, because they're always flat panels.
Exactly.
And flat panels and small flat panels means you can't modify the light, you can't do a lot with it. But what you guys have ingeniously come up with this time is a domed LED,
exactly, yep,
which means you can modify the light, you can put it in a para, you can use it in umbrellas, softboxes,
exactly,
everything.
Yeah.
But there's a lot more to it, isn't there?
There's a lot more to it.
Let's take
a look. So first of all, I agree with you, you know, for a change, you know, I wasn't too much into LEDs, but now it's actually a shapeable LED. So
yes,
it's really, you can even change the lamp head's position. And like this, we bring actually the light source, which is the matte dome, inside the reflector. So all the reflectors, they are calculated for a point,
yes,
you know, a focus point inside the reflector. So it's not like a pre-shaped LED that you can't control.
Zoom it in and out to suit
exactly
the reflector.
And this means that if, you know, on the other side, it has the same bayonet, like all broncolor light shapes, so you can put it in the beauty dish. You said
para,
because the light goes in all directions.
Yeah.
The normal reflectors with the possibility to focus it. Soft boxes, umbrellas, anything you want.
All the range, yeah.
You can use it.
Now, the other thing about this that's quite interesting is variable color temperature.
Yes.
So tell me the color temperature range.
First of all, I'm going to show something more simple, which is there are two presets.
Okay.
Like daylight, you can see it on my hand,
yep,
and if I press this one,
that's daylight now.
That's daylight
and
now, exactly, the other way around.
Yep.
Yeah, exactly.
So
these are two presets,
warm,
yeah,
to cold, or daylight to tungsten.
Exactly. If you're more precise, you just change the frame to Kelvin.
Kelvin, yeah.
Press it, and then you can even go down to 2800K.
Okay. So you can dial in the manual Kelvin temperature.
Exactly. And then on the other side, even more cold or more bluish than daylight, it can go all the way up to 6,800 Kelvin.
Okay, let's talk about one thing that I think people are going to be interested in. Let's talk about brightness. How bright is this thing?
I can show it to you. Also, if I go all the way up to 10.
Right, so super bright now.
Yes, here we need some explanation. So the light is called F160.
Yep.
F, by the way, is for the Focusable, so we can change the position of the lamp head. And 160 is the power in watts.
Okay.
But
watts.
It is the power, I just lower it. It's the power that goes into the lamp head.
Right.
But we as photographers don't really care what's going in. We care what's going out.
What's coming out of it.
And it's coming out, it's about comparable to 650 watts tungsten.
So like a 650 watt modeling lamp.
Exactly.
Right.
So it's very bright, you can actually shoot with it.
Yep.
But additionally, you don't have the oldest tungsten, you really have the adjustable color temperature next to it.
So that's about 2000 lumens.
You ask me now something that I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know.
A 650 watt modeling light's quite bright. I mean, how does it compare to HMI? Because I can imagine two things that this is going to be great for stills, product photography, where you can modify the light, even portrait work, but video as well. Great applications for video with using the paras.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. All the light shapes are accessible. Video, I made a lot of videos with it already. No limitations, and the important thing for me, I'm not a video guy like you, you know.
Mm.
So I'm a photographer, I know the broncolor light strips from the flash equipment, and now I don't have to rethink. Let's say I was shooting this with an opener, with a P70 or with this or with grids, I don't have to rethink what is this now compared in HMI.
Yeah.
What is this in PAR reflectors with the lenses or open face? I don't have to rethink. I just use the same light shape. So very easy for
very
me
easy,
to create moods.
I mean, we use your HMI lights for a lot of our video work. And obviously the HMI lights, I mean, I've got to say it, they're not cheap. This is obviously coming in a lot less expensive than a HMI light.
Exactly.
But you've still got that purity. Now, this is the other factor that concerned me with LED lighting, is the purity of the spectrum, the quality of the spectrum of light, because LEDs have been traditionally known for a long time to be missing parts of the spectrum, not giving good color value, good color readings. What's the color purity?
Yes, okay, very high. But I owe you one more answer from before. You asked me how much light is actually coming out. I couldn't answer the looks.
Okay.
But I'm a photographer, I calculate, or I think in apertures and exposure times. So I was using the LED in a fluter at about 3 meters distance, and I had a 400-404.
Okay.
That's why I remember it. So ISO 400,
yep,
a 1/400 of a second exposure time, and F4. So this just gives you,
so that gives you the idea
an
of
idea
what
how much
out
is coming out.
Yep.
Exactly.
Okay.
But coming back to the light quality, so we measure this in the CRI value.
Yep.
So the sun has 100, because that's
pure daylight.
Pure daylight, exactly. and we have an overall CRI of 97.
97?
97, which is already very high.
Yep.
But we even pushed it to limits if on 5,500K,
yes,
which is the
daylight or
and
flash.
And we actually reach unbelievable 99.
So right.
This is light to reproduce carbon as accurate as possible.
Yeah, almost as accurate as the flash units then.
Yes, as the flash units, because even the flash units reach 100, you know?
Yeah.
Okay. So it's absolutely perfect.
And it's quite a compact unit. Just take the front off for me.
There you go. So make it more compact.
Quite a compact unit there compared. It looks kind of similar to a Syros. Kind of similar to a Syros in design. Compact. What's weight like on it?
Light.
Really light, yeah?
Yes.
So for going in a oh yeah, that is light. Very light.
It is very light,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, very light. So that's a perfect to apply it into a para without tilting the para or being too heavy in the para. Yeah. I'm very interested to try that in a parabolic reflector now that it's got the dome illumination on there. Excellent. Any other features that you want to talk about?
Well, just two more things on the back. We have gone through the presets regarding the color already.
Yep.
And so the power adjustment is very simple, like you know it from the broncolor, in either tenths of an f-stop changes or in full f-stops, you know, from 7 all the way up to 8, it's just one full f-stop more.
Yeah.
We have gone through the color temperature. If you have issues with a magenta green balance, you can even make the fine adjustments here. You can go
tint
a little bit more greenish or a little bit more magenta-ish, you know, that you have really, really,
really fine tuning it.
The light you want. If you used to work with the app, with the bronControl app, or if you want to control it from a DMX, you can as well give the lamp head an address in the menu. So you can call it lamp head number 1, 2, 3, and so on. And like this, you can remote control them with different options.
Yeah, superb. So a lot of applications from video to stills photography, product photography can
absolutely
be really good, still life stuff, but even portraiture and beauty works perfectly possible with this.
This was the most tricky thing because on portrait, I don't want to have exposure times of 1 second. I really shot a lot of portraits, single lights, and it works perfectly.
Great. Oz, we're going to go look at another product shortly, but we're going to do that as a... Oh, everyone wants to know how much it costs. How much is it?
It costs...
$10 million.
No. For you, it's half price. No, it's actually... I can give you Swiss francs.
Swiss francs, yeah.
1,650.
Okay, so we're talking about US dollars. That would be...
Pretty much the same.
Okay, 1,000... What was that?
700.
1,700, $1,600.
Yeah, so depending on the exchange rate, but it will be around the area.
Okay, so not bad. A lot less expensive than a HMI unit.
Absolutely,
Right. Now, you've got another amazing product that you've launched, but we're going to talk about that one in a separate video shortly.
Good.
Thanks very much, Oz.
Thank you.
Very interesting new light.
Nice one, yeah. Thank you.